Welcome back to Titans All Access. Pleased to have Amy Wells joining us now to tell us a story about boyhood friends from the Tri-Cities who had quite a reunion over the weekend in Nashville.
That's right, Mike. Tennessee defensive back Cody Sensabaugh and Blake Leeper have known each other for years, but this past Sunday at LP Field, it was Blake's day to be honored as the 12th Titan. And for him, it was all about support.
12th Titan, Blake Leeper.
Having that many people supporting somebody with a disability is very, very huge. There's so many kids out there that something's wrong, or they think there's nothing out there for them, maybe in a wheelchair, maybe missing a leg. And I hope maybe they can just see my story or see me out on the Titans field and say, hey, I can be like him, or hey, he's overcome his challenge, I can do what he did. And I think that's the whole message that I'm trying to do, and as Cody's trying to do, is just help the youth, change their mindset, letting them know that anything is possible.
So you didn't start running until after high school.
Yeah.
How did that start?
It was pretty cool. I just started running almost about 3.5 years ago. And it was in 2008 where I seen the Paralympic Games and my fellow teammates and competitors that I run against now on TV. Mm-hmm. And right then and there, I was inspired. And I knew that's something I wanted to do. And it was almost a year and a half process. And to go tell people I'm missing my legs, but I want to become a professional runner. Sounds a little crazy to some folks, which I got a lot of no's. I did, but it only takes one yes. And I finally got the right yes, was able to get my first pair of running legs made. And ever since then, my life has taken off. You know, I was able to compete in the Paralympic Games last year, take a silver and bronze home, 3 silvers and a gold this year in the World Championships and a world record. It's just pretty cool to see where I've come, you know, and all the no's I've heard and finally hearing yes in my life and a door finally opening up for me.
Let's go back. How long have you guys been friends?
Years. I can't there's pictures of us. I can remember we've been at family reunions was like 3, 4, 5 years old, you know, playing on Game Boys and stuff like that long ago. Yeah.
We used to play basketball and all that stuff because once we got to middle school, we was inseparable.
So did you guys talk about when you were kids, like, man, one day I want to be a professional athlete, I want to do this, I want to do that, like?
Not in a professional sense, not specifically, but I can remember times when we had conversations where we were like, we're going to do something great.
We were probably 14, 15.
I remember we would just all get together, and one of our other friends, we always all sit together, and we're like, whatever we're going to do, it's going to be something great, and when we do something great, we want to stay together.
So it sounds like your kind of situation and your capabilities were never even an issue for you guys or for you growing up.
No, and I think that was a huge thing. That's why Cody has been so important in my life, is the fact that I have a disability, and certain people are kind of afraid of that disability, want to treat me a little bit different, but this guy right here treated me as if I was a normal human being. And if I was the last guy on the runs, he would tell me to be the first guy. And that was huge for me. That let me know that if he doesn't treat me any different, I shouldn't treat myself any different. Sounds crazy, but you know, the day I was born, they said I'll never walk. And here I am now running for my country, so anything is possible.
Mike, as you can imagine, Blake is an inspiration to people wherever he goes. Despite his disability, he just exudes confidence. And he told me that he is a true believer that one day the fastest man in the world will have no legs. Back to you.